looking for Rufus. That boy can't stay still a minute. Rufus!
This is Rufus and Robert Thomas.
Rufus! Anybody see Rufus? Hey, Rufus! Where is that boy?
Haven. That's when you went to Beale Street, if you had problems or troubles or something away from there, once you got to Beale Street, no problem, no trouble. You whole lot of things to do that you don't have to worry about the problems you had at home or elsewhere. People come from miles around to come to Beale Street. And I told a white fella once, I said, hey man, if you were black for one Saturday night and on Beale Street, never would you want to be white again.
It's kind of the Rufus that we knew. The first two videos were produced at our Music and Heritage Festival in 1982, which was the first time we produced a festival. One of the cool things about knowing Rufus is that I was able to introduce him to many, many people. And one time a guy named Graziano Uliani came to Memphis and he said, Judy, I would love to meet Rufus Thomas. And he did. I introduced Rufus to Graziano, and that had a long-lasting relationship of Rufus and this town in Italy near Bologna. And Rufus is one of the only people I know from Memphis that has a park named from him in a whole other country in Italy, Parco Rufus Thomas, and it's really exciting. So that's kind of my relationship with Rufus and the center's relationship with the man who gave us, showed us the way for music and the way to entertain and be a great performer. I'd like to introduce you to a lot of great performers, and I'd like to introduce you to James Govan and FreeWorld.
She can't so walk in the dog, just so walk in the dog. Well, if you don't know how to do it, show you how to walk the dog. I asked my mama for 15 cents to see the elephant jumped up in. He jumped so high, he touched the sky. Never came back to the 4th of July. Walking the dog, just walking the dog. Well, if you don't know how to do it, show you how to walk the dog. Come on, Herman, walk it on you. Mr. Herman Green, ladies and gentlemen, walking it out. Come on, man. Lima Green, ladies and gentlemen. Come on in. Man, Tutor. I am my mama from 15 cent. See the elephant jumped up him. He jumped on high, he touched the sky. Never came back to the 4th of July. Walking the dog, just walking the dog. Well, if you don't know how to do it, show you how to walk the dog. Now, Mary, Mary, crack a trailer. Tell me, how do your little garden grow? You got silver bells and conker shells, penny babes all in a row, walking the dog, just walking the dog. Well, if you don't know how to do it, show you how to walk a dog. Oh, here we go. Jitter, walking. Jitter, walking. Jitter, walking. Jitter, walking. Well, if you don't know how to do it, show you how to walk a dog. Walking. Walking it down. Free World, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you. They asked me to reflect a little bit about Mr. Thomas. And one thing is Rufus. I had the pleasure of meeting Rufus. And Rufus showed all us a lot and told us a lot. He was a good teacher. And as Judy said, had the pleasure of going over in Italy in Peretta for a number of years with Rufus and performing in Rufus Thomas Park over there, which was a big highlight. And you can imagine, way over in Italy, got a big park named after you. And there was Mr. Thomas, and had the pleasure of working with Rufus, bringing the New Year's in a lot with our band down on Beale Street. So I just like to say, when Richie called me and asked me, they was having a tribute to Rufus. I was honored to be here. And thank you.
Mr. James Govan, ladies and gentlemen. You can catch him down at Rum Boogie Cafe on Beale Street 9 nights a week. Please welcome to the stage the son of Rufus Thomas, a producer, engineer, musician extraordinaire. Y'all give it up one time. Mr. Marvell Thomas.
Great, thank you. Tonight everybody's gonna do a little bit of reflecting on their relationships, experiences with Rufus Thomas. Rufus Thomas was a mentor. He always had a big smile on his face. He knew how to make people feel at home. He made them laugh. Those are most of the things that people who know Rufus Thomas know about already. I'm going to explore a couple of small things that you probably don't know. And they are things that have to do with Rufus Thomas, the father, the family man. He kind of chokes me up a little. I remember when I was a small child, I used to look forward to weekends when my father would take me. I was 4, 5, 6 years old. He worked at a textile mill in his early days, and he would bring home from the textile mill materials like brown paper and string and things like that. And he would take me out in the woods. We actually had some woods around here. We still have some. And he would take a knife and cut pieces from a tree, a small tree, to make a frame for a homemade kite. And he would put this frame together, and he would cover it with brown paper and paint pictures on it and use one of his old neckties for a tail for the kite. And we'd spend the day out in the middle of nowhere, I never knew where I was, flying a kite using the string that he brought home from the textile plant. And the memory of those weekends has stuck with me all this time. I never forget it, and it's, to me, a big part of my childhood, and I will forever love him for that. So, on with the show. Outside of the table, there is a booklet or a book that on your way out, and some people who are just coming in, walk by, they check by a table. There's a book that I don't think anybody's ever seen before that is called The Life and Times of Rufus Thomas, full of pictures and small stories and all sorts of interesting things that people who love Rufus Thomas will find fascinating and great for their collections and their archives. So check the books out at a table in the lobby right out front there. They're $20, and the proceeds are designed to go to the Rufus Thomas Scholarship Fund. So if you would stop by the table and pick up a book, you'll really like it. I kind of put it together, and I'm really happy with the way it came out, mostly because there were some other people involved in putting it together beside me. But stop by the table on your way out and pick up one of the books. And if you feel like it, I can autograph it for you if you wish. So please check out the table and pick up a book. You'll love it. Thank you very much.
You want me to bring up Vaneese?
Okay. Next on program is, I don't know why they had me introducing her, but I guess I'm as good a person as any. If you all would give a great Memphis rousing, thank you. That was kind of rousing, but a young lady who has spent most of her music career away from Memphis. She's been in New York for a few years, quite a few years, and has done recordings and with all kinds of people. She's worked with David Sanborn and Luther Vandross and all kinds of folks. I won't even go into her resume, that'd take a while. She also has a couple of her own albums, which are also on a table outside. And take a listen to those too, because you will be surprised. And so without further ado, I'll bring to the stage my baby sister, Vaneese Thomas.
Hello, there we are. How's everybody? Before I, it's kind of warm in here, huh? But I'm so glad to see so many of you. Fans in hand and braving the weather and the, hello? We got a little ring happening, but he's gonna work on that, right? Braving the weather and braving the heat and the humidity to be here for this tribute. And first of all, I want to thank Judy, the board of the Center for Southern Folklore, and all of you for making this possible. I thank you. Whoa, and that one right in my eyes. I won't be standing there. Ah, that's better. Huh. I want to start with a reflection before I sing. The thing that Marvell told you is amazingly touching, and I don't think I ever heard that before.
No.
Uh-uh. Well, stick with me, kid. He says, stick with me, kid. I got a million of them. My reflection is, I went to Hamilton High School. Any Hamiltonians in here? There we go. And in those days, it was the elite, the certainly the black intelligentsia, because in those days it was still all African American. And Hamilton High School had a great chorus, but I was in the chorus, yeah, but I didn't care about that stuff. I wanted to be a majorette. And my mother was like, don't do that because it's so cold out and you're going to catch cold and you're going to have arthritis later in your life. She was right. But the times I remember most fondly are the times with when Daddy was in town and that he would come to the football games. And before I'd go on, he'd be in the stands. He'd hold my coat, and when I came off the field after marching, he'd be there at the end of the goal line with my coat to wrap me back up. It's a precious, precious memory for me. So that's a real personal one. That was my daddy. So I'm going to start this little set. I'm just going to do a couple of numbers. But one is a song, and Marvell can back me up on this. Daddy had been signed to a new record label in town. It was called Cadre. If anybody remembers when that was happening, was it Union Planners Bank building, Marvell? Huh? The Cadre. What was the name of the building? Hey!
The Cadre building.
The Cadre, well, okay. It was an old bank building. And it was going to be the up-and-coming thing. They were signing people. Daddy had a new contract. And it was going to be a blues record. So my friend, Nick Morrock, with whom I work in New York, he plays with David Sanborn, and I wrote this song and sent it down to Marvell because he was going to produce this record on Daddy. And unfortunately, Daddy never got to record it. Yeah, that too. They ran off with the money. Or I'm sorry, they closed. But then Daddy, passed away, so we were unable to ever get it recorded. And so I decided to record it on my Soul Sister album, and it's called Oh Lord, It's Killing Me. Here like the blues? Well, if you do, you can put your hands together. Trying to stay on the right track, don't know where to turn. Lonely blues done found me, I guess that's a lesson learned. Work is it's hard to find. Baby needs new shoes. Nobody seemed to love me. That's why I sang these blues. Because, Lord, it's killing me. Ooh. I said, Lord, 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 it's killing me. Won't somebody please hear my plea? I said, Lord, 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 it's killing me. Oh, can you sing it? Oh, two more times. Oh, that's all right. My baby's got a new girl, gone and put me down. Left without a warning, he didn't want me around. What did I do to deserve this pain and agony? The lonely blues confound me, and I need some release. I said, Lord, it's killing me. Oh, yes, it is. I said, Lord, it's killing me. Hey, hey. Won't somebody please hear my plea? Oh, yeah. I said, Lord, 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 it's killing me. Oh, yeah. Oh, life is kind of hard sometimes. Oh, yeah. Oh.
Like to be without a little ready cash.
It's killing me.
Oh, don't play like you ain't never been broke.
It's killing me.
The economy ain't so good.
It's killing me.
And everybody out there may have experienced not having a job.
It's killing me.
Well, if you know what I'm talking about, let me see a hand go
it's
up.
It's killing me.
So you know what I'm talking
it's
about.
It's killing me.
And have you ever experienced, bring it down a little bit. Have you ever experienced losing a love? You love that person with all your heart and soul. All right.
it's killing me.
And that person just gets up one day,
it's killing
and leaves you alone.
Yeah, it's killing me.
Anybody know what I'm talking about out there? Wave a hand, wave a hand, wave a hand. Yeah,
it's killing me.
Cause I ain't playing up here. Okay, this is for real.
It's killing me.
So you know what I'm talking about. Hard times. Oh yeah,
it's killing me.
Hard times, everybody knows some hard times.
It's killing me.
Baby gonna lift you. Yes, she did.
It's killing me.
Left without a warning. Oh, yes, he did.
It's killing me.
Well, you know, like they say in the country song. What does the country song
it's
say? If you play it backwards, I bet you know that joke, don't you?
Mm-hmm.
Well, it
it's
means
me.
Your dog come back that ran away. Your
it's
wife came back
me.
That ran away. And you get all your money back.
It's killing me.
Somebody bring you back your truck.
Somebody bring you back your truck.
It's killing me.
So that's what life can be like.
It's killing me.
Life can be so hard sometimes. Tell them y'all.
It's killing me.
This is Paul. Everybody say, thank you, Paul.
It's killing me.
That's Berneta. Thank you, Berneta. And that's Sheryl on
it's
the end. Thank you, Sheryl.
Me.
These people are here because they loved Mr. Rufus Thomas.
It's killing me.
And I feel blessed to have them up here singing with me tonight. Come on, let's have a hand for the background
it's
singers.
It's killing me.
Oh, yeah.
It's killing me.
All right, you can sing. Oh, yeah.
It's killing me.
Come on.
It's killing me. It's killing me. It's killing me.
All right. Thank you. Thank you for loving the Memphis blues. This next song is something that my father did right here on this stage as well as outdoors on those stages since 1982 for the Center for Southern Folklore. You'll recognize it when we start it up. You ready? Are you ready for it? All right,
one,
here we go.
Two, three, four.
Anybody recognize this song? Sit down and be all quiet. Come on. Let's get in the groove. Come on and move, move, move. Here we go. Said, honey, baby, I've been told you know how to shake your butter bowl. I got to see for myself if you got any butter left. Here we go. Break down to the left. Break down to the right. Break down to the one you're gonna love tonight. Oh, do the breakdown, sugar. Break on down. Do the breakdown, sugar. Break on down. I said, you got it going. My, my, my. Just look around and grab your guy. Stop where you are and let your big hip rock. I can show you your love can drop. Hey,
break down for me, break down for you, break down to the one you wanna give it to.
Oh,
do the breakdown, children.
All right,
break on down. Do the breakdown, children. Break on down.
Come on now. From Herman. Mm-hmm. supposed to be. Do it in the evening, late at night. I'm gonna show you breakdown is all right. Mama can do it, Papa too. Grandma, Grandpa, they're doing it too. Do it in the evening, late at night. I'm gonna show you breakdown is all right. Come on, y'all.
Do the breakdown, chug.
Do it.
Break on down. Do the breakdown, chug. Break on down.
Come on now.
Do the breakdown, chug.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Break on down.
Break on down.
Do the breakdown, chug.
Oh.
Break on down.
Let's break it on down. All right. Now this is the time that I teach everybody in the audience how to do the breakdown. Anybody out there know how to do the breakdown? Oh, I see a couple of hands, but unfortunately either I'm too old or you're too young to remember the dance. Here we go. Do you wanna see it? 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 Well, I'm gonna do it for you. I'm gonna do it for you. I'm gonna do it for, who used to say that? I'm gonna do it for you. Here we go. You know, I combine a little of the funky chicken and the breakdown. And you know, it makes it easy to teach people, so here we go. I tell people, Daddy used to do in the penguin, you put your left arm up, a little bit more, and your right arm too. Well, that's what we're gonna do for the breakdown. All right. Thank you, Paul. Superman. Here we go. Everybody in your seats, you put your left arm up and your right arm too. I'm gonna show you just what to do. Say, you go up, down, up, down, up, and down. Up, you don't have to be stiff. Down, up. That's, oh, that brother in the back right there in the black t-shirt got it. Woo! Can you get through the crowd? I want you to see this brother. Come on up here. Yeah, you. Come on, check him out. Check him out. Woo! All right, so let's do it, group. You put your left arm up and your right arm too. I'm gonna show ya just what to do. You go up, down, up, down. Come on now. Yeah, yeah, hey, yeah. Everybody's doing the breakdown. Y'all look so good. I hope they get pictures of this, 'cause y'all are swinging. Oh, do the breakdown, chug.
Break on down. Do the breakdown, chug.
Oh, yeah.
Break on down. Break on down. Do the breakdown, chillin'.
Oh, yeah.
Break on down.
You know you can do it.
Do the breakdown, chillin'.
Yeah.
Break on down.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Do the breakdown, chillin'.
Hey, yeah.
Break on down.
Do the breakdown. Woo! 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 Thank you so much. On behalf of Mr. Rufus Thomas and our family, we thank you for coming tonight.
Yesterday at the end of rehearsal, Vaneese and Marvell were sitting over there talking about the set list, and I told them this little story, and they suggested that I tell it here. But everybody has those little snapshots in your life that just stick with you forever and ever. I was playing a little club on Beale Street down there with a corner patio, doing an acoustic duo where we were playing a lot of Eagles and James Taylor and that kind of stuff. And about once a month or so, Rufus would start. He would come walking up third, and then he would walk around on Beale for a little while, and then 20, 30 minutes later, maybe an hour, he would walk back to the car. And I always wanted to say something to him, but I was always nervous. I never really... And then one time he was walking past, and I I started playing. I started playing that, and he was walking, stopped and turned around and gave me one of the biggest, most beautiful smiles I have ever seen in my life, and just kind of, and then turned right around and kept walking. One of the coolest moments of my life. You know, everybody talks about funky Broadway, and everybody talking about funky Philadelphia, but I want to tell you about my hometown, funky Bahia, Mississippi.
Come and go with me now, down to Mississippi. Come and go with me now, down in Mississippi.
Now some of y'all know Vaneese, right? How many people down there know Vaneese? Raise your hand, you know Vaneese. You know not to speed through there, right? Because they will pull you over. Like a... See, now we got a street that they call Town Street. And that's where all the groovy country people meet. And on every corner, they got a greasy spoon. And they do the boogaloo just like they want to. Now we don't have hippies down in Mississippi, but we're funky, funky just the same. Funky Mississippi, funky Mississippi.
Come on, y'all sing that with me.
Funky Mississippi, funky Mississippi.
Hey, Richard, Richard, come on, play me some of that funky bass like you know what I mean. Yeah, I like that. Kind of music makes you want to go do something. Yeah. Hey, Marvell, play me some of that. Play me some of that funky piano. Play me some of that. Yeah, I like that. That's nice. Oh, that's what I call real funky. The only place you can hear that is down in Mississippi. You know what I'm saying? Here we go.
Come and go with me now, down in Mississippi. Oh, come and go with me now, down in Mississippi. But we're funky, funky, just the same. Funky Mississippi, funky Mississippi, funky Mississippi, funky Mississippi.
Marvell specifically wanted to do that song. I was one of his favorite Rufus Thomas songs of all. That was definitely a Rufus Thomas song. It's fair. I asked him earlier when he picked it out. I said, are you specifically like trying to mess with me on that? No hippies in Miss. Come on now. My Rufus Thomas memory actually comes from the Memphis Music and Heritage Festival about 1995, back when it was over the grass area next to Morgan Keegan, and there was a big stage there, and if you could have looked down sort of from overhead as Rufus was playing and the band was smoking and kicking and there was all this frenzy of people going nuts, right in the middle of it was a guy standing there going. And that was me. And I was mesmerized. I was watching this man. How is he doing this? I mean, he owns everybody here. He's just right here in the palm of his hand. It was so integral to me trying to develop something even in the vicinity of that. But it was, I remember Rufus from that. Actually, I believe the picture out there on the wall is from that night. And it was just an amazing thing. If you would please put your hands together for Marvell's other little sister. You know her and you love her, ladies and gentlemen. Please welcome to the stage, Ms. Carla Thomas.
Carla Thomas, and I'm the second born, and when they looked at me, they said, oh, what a beautiful baby. Oh, well, I don't know if that's true or not. Well, we're gonna try one for you, see if you remember this one. Everybody get ready for me. We're gonna put our hands together. Come on. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Oh, yeah, yeah. Baby, oh, baby. I love to call you baby. Baby, oh, baby. I love to call you baby. When you squeeze. And I can't stop loving you. And I won't stop calling you. Baby,
baby.
Oh, baby. You look so good to me, baby. Baby,
baby.
Oh, baby. You are so good to me, baby. Just one look in your eyes. And my temperature goes sky high. Oh, I'm weak for you and can't help it. I really don't wanna help it. Swing, y'all.
B-A-B-Y,
oh, I'm talking
B-A-B-Y,
about
B-A-B-Y, baby.
Whenever the sun don't shine, you throw out the lifeline, and I get real close to you and your sweet kisses.
Baby,
I like to call it
baby,
baby.
You know, years ago they called it, let's bring it on down. Yeah, whoop. I don't know where they got that stuff from, but it just sold. Come on, y'all, come on.
B-A-B.
Yeah, that's how they all put it together, just like that.
B-A-B-Y, baby.
Hear me calling.
B-A-B-Y, baby. B-A-B-Y, baby.
Talk to me.
B-A-B-Y,
oh, in the morning.
B-A-B-Y, baby.
And then we said, give me a little soul guitar back there, come on. Whatever you feel, come on. That's how we used to put the things together in the studio, just whatever. Give me a. Y'all got me up here, thank you. Oh, I love you, thank you, man. So what do I do now? Oh, no, I'm not gonna
leave. Let's bring Vaneese back out here again. Hey, don't forget, this festival is free and it goes on your donations. Please make sure to put something in the bucket for the Center for Southern Folklore.
Well, while we're doing reflections, I don't know if any of you remember, you see now where the New Daisy is? Well, that was a place called the Palace Theater. Anybody remember the Palace? A lot of blues stars and other artists got their start on Beale Street, but I remember it as a way of life for African-American people. That was a place called the New Daisy, and every Saturday we would have the, what do you call it, the series? Like you all have the soapbox now? Tune in tomorrow for. Well, I was tune in next Saturday, and Daddy and a lot of the kids who lived in the projects where we grew up, would hold hands and he'd take us all, I don't know, the parents just trusted him, we would hold hands and go over to the New Daisy to see Tarzan. Man, Tarzan was my man. Man, he took care of the natives, man. And I love my daddy because he took me every Saturday to see Tars. You know what I'm saying? So, I mean, all these little kids would be sitting there, oh, Tarzan, what is he going to do next week? And that's how we got our entertainment. We didn't just change channels to see something or wait till tomorrow. And Daddy was kind of the focal point. He would take all these kids from the foothills over there and take us to see the movie. And then he would sit us down on some days and teach us the ham bone.
I'll hold this while you ham bone.
Oh, no, I thought you were going to do the ham bone.
I'm the only Thomas child that can't ham bone. Marvell can and Carla can.
But I can't. Do anybody remember the ham bone? Who out there is brave enough to show me the ham bone?
Oh, there she go. There she go.
I mean, right on time.
Yes. Come on, stand up, let them see you.
See, we didn't have a drum. This was it.
Right, we didn't have. Don't need no drummer.
We don't need no music.
Right.
We don't need no music. We don't need no music. Now you gonna try to make me break my back. But wait a minute.
Why don't you get up and do it too?
Yeah, can you do it? But anyway, all these little kids, and now there's a course called Orff Music. You all know that. Anybody knows who's come up, there's an Orff Music course that teaches you how to do rhythm. And they have names now like ostinato. So one ostinato says, another one says, we did this stuff all the time. So you could put about 20 of those ostinatos together and you know what you got, a fabulous thing. Well, my daddy was doing stuff like that all the time. And what I remember is I'm glad I had a daddy like daddy who taught me and wasn't afraid to show me what rhythm was and what he wasn't afraid to show me what a daddy was. I miss you, daddy, but it's so many people still love you. Thank you. Hey, man.
Oh, check, check, check. Carla, what year was this next song recorded? '62 or '63?
Oh, nighttime. No, mm-hmm. I don't know.
Well, it was a big hit. Could I have a little more in this monitor, please? It was a big hit for Ray Charles, but Memphians remember the version by Rufus and Carla Thomas.
Amen.
Here we go.
Well, you know the nighttime is the right time to be with the one you love. Oh, baby, my baby, be with the one you love. Oh, yeah. You know the nighttime, hey, is the right time to be with the one you love.
and gentlemen.
Thank you very much. Thank you so much. Thank you for your love. Thank you.
Say something, honey. Come on, let's hear it, ladies and gentlemen. Miss Carla Thomas. Ladies and gentlemen, we're going to bring back up Funky Man in his own right, Mr. James Govan.
Hey, Herman. Could you turn up the trumpet mic and let Herman say something for a minute? Please, Mike.
Test. Can you hear me out there? Oh, that's okay, then that's good. Now, I have a lot to say, but it would take too much to say it. But this wonderful family, the Thomas family, Rufus raised me. I was 15 years old when I played on this first record. And then I got a chance to see all of my youngsters that you see on this stage grow up under Mr. Thomas. And he was just like a father to me as well. And I played with him for quite a many years. And so it's a pleasure to be here to relive this visit with Carla, Vaneese, and Marvell. Let's give it to him.
Mr. Herman Green, a legend, not just in Memphis, but worldwide saxophone player. Let's have a hand from Herman Green.
Now we're going to take it home with a classic Rufus Thomas Memphis song. You may have heard this one before. I think I hear it coming. You hear it coming?
Here it comes.
There it comes. Here comes that Memphis train, y'all. All aboard! Woo!
Come on, Memphis. Woo! This train is about to
talk about that Memphis train, y'all.
Train number one is gone. Train number two is gone. Train number three has been gone. How long must I wait for you?
Woo! How long I gonna wait for you, baby? We gonna take that train up to Chicago, then we going down to New Orleans.
Hey! When I drop my handkerchief on the floor, I'm getting ready to call. When I see you calling on the floor, I'm getting ready to crawl. I said, ooh-wee,
the Memphis train. I said, ooh-wee, the Memphis train.
He said, ain't I clean?
Yes, indeed.
He said, now, ooh-wee, the Memphis train. I said, ooh-wee, the Memphis train.
Go on, Marvell. Take a ride, Marvell.
Yeah.
in this train.
Can y'all sing that out there?
Ooh-wee, the Memphis train.
That sounds good. Sounds like a train whistle. Do that ooh.
Ooh-wee, the Memphis train.
Everybody, come on, come on.
Ooh-wee, the Memphis train.
Go Rufus, go Rufus, go Rufus, go Rufus.
So unnecessary of it.
All right. I just want to say thank you first to Judy Peiser and the Center for Southern Folklore. Let's have a hand for this. Come on, come on, that's not enthusiastic. Come on. And I want to thank every musician up here, starting over there with Herman, Charles, Pete, Richard, Dave, Matt. Was it? James Govan, ladies and gentlemen. Give up his heart and his love. Paul, Berneta, and Sheryl. Everybody up here. And Miss C.T. We want to thank everyone and remind you that there are CDs and books. It's called Hoot and Holler. Anybody remember WDIA? Daddy's show was called Hoot and Holla.
The Memphis Train.
And that was his intro when he came on the air. I'm young, I'm loose, I'm full of juice. I got the goose, so what's the use? I'm feeling gay, though I ain't got a dollar. Old Rufus is here, so let's hoot and holla.
The Memphis Train.
All right now, that's the Rufus we know and love. So don't forget to pick up a book.
The Memphis Train.
And pick up a CD. And don't let Memphis music die.
The Memphis Train.
Support your Memphis music.
The Memphis Train.
I'd like to bring up Miss Judy Peiser.
Thomas family, this is a fabulous night. Let's hear it, y'all. I can't hear you. Much better. Much better. Even Jack Bells will hear that one. Listen, there's still music going on, but this was the creme de la creme. Only Rufus would know how special this is. Thanks for Vaneese for coming in town. Thanks for Marvell for getting off the damn phone so we could talk to him. Thanks to Carla for coming by on Vanessa's birthday, and she sang happy birthday.
Hey, Judy, what about that artwork?
Simon, come on up here. Simon, we've got a guy who lives in England, but he loves Memphis music and Rufus Thomas. Simon.
I'm just an artist from England who's a really big fan of Rufus and Carla Thomas, so I just want to give this painting to Carla and the family.
Thank you.
There's one of Carla and Rufus.
He's nervous, y'all. Let's thank him.
Thank you.
Here it is, Rufus and WDIA. We've got people from all over the world, you know, that love him. You guys, thank you so much. I just want to let you know that We do have T-shirts with the Rufus picture on it. It's a fabulous picture. And posters for sale along with the book. We hope that you stick and stay because Kate Campbell will be up in about 20 minutes with another awesome show. We are so glad that everybody came to the Memphis Music and Heritage Festival. It ain't nothing but a party, folks. And you got a few more hours to party, and you got a few more hours to put the money in the basket.